All right, tonight, a stunning report that one of Harvey Weinstein's most vocal accusers allegedly sexually assaulted a young man. Encrypted documents sent to the New York Times reveal that Asia Argento paid $380,000 to a young man, an actor and a musician named Jimmy Bennett, who played her son in a film in 2004. Look at them here. This is them in a movie scene together. He, at the time there, was just 7 years old. Bennett is now 22, and he is claiming that Argento sexually assaulted him in 2013 at a California hotel when she was 37 and he was 17. The age of consent in California is 18. Now, Argento, of course, you know her because she has emerged as a leading voice in the Me Too movement and has alleged that she was raped by Harvey Weinstein when she was 21 years old. Out front now, the New York Times reporter who broke the story, Kim Severson, joins me. Kim, thank you for being here. Before we get into how these documents ended up in your inbox, tell us more about what you're reporting, what Bennett is alleging here, because sexual battery is among the charges. It's very disturbing.
Right. It was a long list of charges in this intent to sue notice that we got. And it was emotional distress. It was sexual battery. It was assault. A number of charges that really stem from this one afternoon or morning, actually, at a hotel room in Marina Del Rey in 2013.
In your article, you talk about how you got these documents and that they were sent to not only the New York Times, to your inbox through encrypted right. email, and they were sent from an unidentified party. Do you have any better understanding tonight of who sent these to you?
You know, we have a pretty solid idea of how they came to us.
Okay.
But without solid confirmation, we, of course, took these documents. It came after I'd been reporting on Anthony Bourdain's suicide and previously had been reporting on some of the Me Too movement stories that came out of the restaurant world. I write about food and had been talking to people in the Bourdain camp and talking to people who knew him and who knew he and Asia's relationship. And then I had gotten wind of something about this story maybe a month and a half ago and kept asking about it and trying to pull strings. We knew a few things here and there, but nothing that was reportable or verifiable. And then in a series of a couple of emails, these documents trickled in. Two of them were particularly key because they were signed by attorneys. So we were able to go back and verify the documents. I mean, obviously, we aren't in the business of taking things over the transom and running them in the paper.
Right.
So we spent a lot of time verifying okay. these from different sources.
I mean, Kim, still, I think it's stunning that still no response to you, right? No response at all from Argento or her team.
We've spent a lot of time. We had the reporter in our Rome bureau had interviewed Asia extensively regarding the Harvey Weinstein material.
Right.
And, you know, he had a relationship with her. He reached out. I reached out.
Nothing.
We know that her attorney had gotten our emails and requests for interviews because she had called other sources, called two of the other attorneys involved. So they clearly don't want to talk about this right now.
So, I mean, again, Argento says she was raped by Harvey Weinstein. And Weinstein's lawyer is capitalizing on this tonight, responding in part. Let me read part of it. This development reveals a stunning level of hypocrisy by Asia Argento, one of the most vocal catalysts who sought to destroy Harvey Weinstein. Two things can be true at the same time, right? It's important to point out here what she is alleging, many other women are alleging, happened to them as well.
Right, and Ms. Argento was not part of the six charges that Harvey Weinstein are facing, Harvey Weinstein's facing. And, you know, this is the thing that seems essential here is that one person does not make an entire movement, and we don't know what Ms. Argento's side of this was. So I think there's a lot to be considered. But, the idea that this one incident would somehow unravel an entire case against Harvey Weinstein and this young social movement that we find ourselves in the middle of is kind of crazy.
All right, Kim, really important reporting. Kim Severson of The Times, thank you for being with me.
You're welcome.